Jenny Bond, the veteran royal reporter, previously cautioned Meghan Markle over her massively extravagant spending, warning that the public disliked it, unearthed reports show. With decades of royal experience under her belt, Bond has an unmatched understanding of the workings of the firm. The official introduction of Meghan Markle into the royal family in 2018 marked for many a new era, akin to 1981 when Princess Diana married Prince Charles. Royal watchers were hopeful that the former actress would help modernize the family and bring it into the 21st century. Bond, however, became acutely aware of how Meghan's actions might translate to the public. Speaking to Yahoo Life, she warned the Duchess of Sussex over what she described as her massively extravagant spending. She said, "What I think that Meghan has to be careful of is that she's so, pretty much A-list celebrity as well as senior royal. I am getting the feeling that the public don't like her terrifically spending huge quantities of money. Being extravagant, massively extravagant, she can afford it, she is a wealthy woman, but it doesn't play very well, so I think she needs to just watch that." Jenny added, "I think I'd suggest she tried not to be too celebrity, because that doesn't go down well with the public, and try to ignore the fact she's getting flack from various directions." Princess Diana was a close pal of journalist Jenny, who she believes Meghan is often unfairly compared to, insisting Meghan is much more mature than she is portrayed to be. She concluded, "She is much more mature. Much more knowing of her role and the issues she wishes to espouse. Much readier for the role than Diana ever was." At the time, much had been said of Meghan's designer wardrobe, which, according to the Mail, totaled to more than £500,000. The publication reported that during a three-day tour of Morocco in February 2019, Meghan's clothing totaled more than an estimated £110,000 during her three-day tour of Morocco with Harry, thanks to a kaftan-style Dior gown believed to be worth as much as £90,000. Offering Meghan some advice, Bond added, "I think I'd ask Meghan, suggest to her that she tries not to play any games with the press. Try not to be too celebrity, because that doesn't go down well with the public, and to try to ignore the fact that she's getting quite a lot of flack from various directions." But, within 6 months of the interview being aired, Meghan and Harry were bound for a life post-royal family. In January 2020, they made the bold move to relinquish ties with the firm and move across the pond to Canada, later heading south and crossing the border to live in Meghan's native California where they currently reside. They have since moved to push their own brand, Archewel, and with it help the world with many of its problems. Within Archewel is the couple's business division in which they have a media branch to help produce content for Netflix and Spotify. This week, David Furnish, Elton John's husband who has been working with Meghan on her first Netflix project, lapped praise on the Duchess. Helping to create Pearl, Furnish told an audience at the Hello! Inspiration Awards that she was amazing and a fantastic collaborator. He said, "She's, Meghan, a fantastic collaborator, amazing leader. And we're just very, very excited to be working with, you know, someone as influential and as supportive as Netflix." Pearl marks the first time the Suits star has turned her hand to working as a creator and executive producer on a TV series. Bond is best known for having worked as the BBC's royal correspondent for 26 years. She has detailed in length just how difficult a job it was, having to be near a phone around the clock in case something happened or was announced at the palace. In her later years, Bond was able to take her foot off the gas after retiring from her full-time role.